Hi Aquarius, so we're gonna go ahead and get right into this reading. I'm actually filming on a different camera because I don't have my iPad right now, but we're gonna go ahead and get right into this. It's gonna be a very general reading. Stop, pay attention. All right, everything to my me is down below. If you definitely want to book a personal reading, that would also be down below. The turnaround time is 3 to 5 days. However, if you want your reading the same day or 24 hours, you can book an emergency reading. Also, what I was gonna say is, I just wanna go ahead and give you guys a heads up. I will not be doing live readings on Thursday and Friday of this week coming up. I'll be doing them on Tuesday and Thursday. Excuse me, I don't know, I said Tuesday and Thursday. Yeah. What is that? Thing, you know, Tuesday and Wednesday. Sorry y'all, I got it mixed up. So I'm gonna be doing readings on Tuesday and Wednesday, okay? Because I won't be here, okay? Also, what I was gonna say is feel free to like, comment, subscribe. All right, check out my other channels. I did put up a ton of new channel messages on TikTok. If you don't have me on TikTok, my only TikTok is ashcashtruee444. Feel free to check out the community tab on all of the pages. All right, Life with Ashley Allure, Ashley Allure's Edition, and this channel, which is Ashley Allure. All right, guys, so we're gonna go ahead and get right into this reading. I'm not gonna do too much talking and chit chatting and all that stuff, all right? But you read the title. You know what it's about, okay? Somebody's on the down low. Mm-hmm. Yeah, somebody's on the down low, collective. And I feel like, more importantly, this is what you need to know. You could also be seeing a 111, okay? Or seeing those numbers, or this person could be seeing it. For some of you guys here, you or them could have pimply skin. Somebody could be having like an outbreak all of a sudden, or you could have like plans with this person, or, you know, gonna link up with them, gonna hang out with them, all right? That could be a significance, but yeah, this person's on that down low. All right, let's see what y'all need to know about the situation, all right? But yeah, like I said, this person's on the down low with the Three of Cups and the Seven of Pentacles, all right? The reason why this reading coming out, I'm guessing, is because this person, they could be like, you could have plans with this person. This could be like to go out and get drinks, go party, or, you know, if this is like your first time meeting up with them, this could be like, oh, okay, you know, let's get to know each other, let's see what everything is about. Take the reading how it resonates for you. But like I said, with the Seven of Pentacles energy here, this is like what you get. You get what you get, you know what you fit. But Seven of Pentacles, also, this person could be getting like rewards or external validation or whatever it is, okay, from the same sex, whether they're a man or a female, all right, or they like this, okay. But understand that whoever this person is, yeah, with the Magician card and the Six of Wands energy, they may be able to pass, okay. You know, pass is like when somebody's like, I guess they call them trades, okay, where they're able to like trade their identity, like by day they're masculine or they're feminine, and then by night they're like LGBTQ, or like they're really their true self or their true form or whatever. But yeah, somebody's in the DL with the Six of Wands energy, and I feel like more importantly with the Six of Wands, they are very successful at manipulating the crowd, having a good time, more importantly fooling people into thinking that they're not DL or keeping this in the closet, okay. But the thing is that with this person is, child, yeah, this is somebody here who, more importantly, here with the Lover's card. For some of you guys, this could be your lover. Either this is your lover, and for some of you guys, it could be your ex that you're linking up with. But for some of you guys, this is your current lover, somebody new that you recently met or you're going to meet. All right, but yeah, I'm sitting here with the Two of Pentacles. This person is definitely going to be juggling you, or if you have suspicions, this person is juggling you. They are, but you could have been like, damn, I don't see no women, or, you know, like if it's a man, you're like, damn, I don't see no women, or like if you are a woman, you could be like, damn, I don't see no, well, y'all know what I'm saying. If you're in a heterosexual relationship and you're thinking of the opposite sex, but you're not really finding evidence you're looking for, or something is like not right, or you're trying to figure out, everything looks right, sounds right, is right, no, this is what's going on, okay? And whoever this person is, like I said, Six of Wands energy, this person could be very successful at juggling you or keeping this facade up, keeping this priority up, y'all. But I'm getting with the Hierophant card here. Your ancestors, your spiritual team here could be definitely be letting you know about the commitment you have with this person, or if they're being non-committal for some of you guys here, this is the reason why. But as you guys, like I said, with the Hierophant card here, this could also be the reason why they're not like being out in the open with your situation, if you, however you're dealing with them. But yeah, with the Five of Swords energy, this is somebody here who wants to win at all costs, or like, more importantly, they could be a little greedy, they could be a little selfish when it comes to getting what they want, all right, or getting what they want by any means. Yeah, for some of you guys, Eight of Pentacles energy, this person could say like they're at work, or, you know, they're going to invest in something that's beneficial to them, whether it's like getting money, having a great time. This could be like putting in some type of time, effort, energy, or whatever it is, but no, this is what they're doing, or this is who they're spending time with, all right? But yeah, with the Magician card energy, with some of you guys here, this could literally be like their co-worker, like however they work. They could be a creative, or whatever's going on here. Hold on, y'all. Hold on, y'all. I gotta order my wings. My little lash just fell off. That is so crazy. But yeah, that's what's going on. Eight of Swords. This person has made their bed and it's time for them to lie in it. But I feel like what's going on with the Two of Wands energy, this person could be trying to make some decision, or more importantly, time has ran out, either with the Hangman trade card for this person to tell you so they can move forward, or things can move forward. Or more importantly, for some of you guys here, this is somebody you used to deal with in the past. Understand that, understand that with the Two of Cups and Nine of Pentacles, this person may act single, but they're not really single, or vice versa to you. All right. But yeah, this is what's going on. Give me 1 second, y'all. Let me order my food and come back. Sorry about that, y'all. But yeah, let's get back into this reading. I feel like what's going on, at this current time being here, you could be watching this video because maybe your life is on autopilot, or like that song Mila J. It's like, I'm vibing, I'm chilling, I'm good, I'm kicking back and I'm vibing, I'm chilling, I'm good. Like, that could be the kind of vibe that you're giving off, all right? And whoever this person is, they don't understand that you're bulletproof. So like, any type of sneaky shit, lame shit, or weird shit that they try to pull. Yeah, Three of Wands energy. This can be like trying to make future plans or moves, trying to figure out what should be their best move, okay? Or to create something with you, or get something started. Like Michael Jackson says, want to be starting something. That shit ain't gonna happen. Yo, spiritual team don't play with you like that. Oh, more importantly, play with people like that. Let them play with you like that. So, more importantly. Okay. But anyways, more importantly, yeah, there gonna be like a lot of interruptions, okay, when it comes to like you talking to this person, dealing with them, seeing them, or there could be like small mishaps or problems, or this going on, that going on, things are not aligning, and this is the reason why. All right, I feel like also for some of you guys here, you either canceled plans on this person, or they have canceled plans on you. Also, for some of you guys here, if you're into candlework, you could definitely light a trooper rose of candle, okay, or hummingbirds could be of significance here. But yeah, whoever this person is, like I said, with the Four of Swords energy, they make their bed, it's time for the lying it, but I feel like your intuition is beaming right now. You might know that something is up or something is wrong with the Magician card, but you're not really sure what's going on, even though this person is manifesting you, or you could be manifesting this person. Your spiritual team is High Priestess manifesting you to find out this secret or this truth. All right, with the Seven of Cups energy, and maybe you have options, or this person has options, but more importantly, it's giving like get creative about it, or more importantly, creative communication is of significance here. All right, but yeah, whoever this person is, honey, let's see what they're thinking, okay? And I'm sitting here with the Eight of Wands and the Wheel of Fortune. This person could be waiting for communication, either from you here, wanting to text, call, email you with the Star card. More important, this person don't really care if they break your heart. The Star card. The person might not really care if they break your heart here with the Hierophant card and the World card. But your ancestors want to put an end to this, or they want to put a stop to this here. Because I feel like... Hold on, y'all. Because I feel like, more importantly, what's going on with the Ten of Cups energy with the Page of Cups, this person can be very fickle, or like you may think that they're good news or something great for long term, or you may like their vibe. Whole time your ancestors like, you're not really fucking with the Queen of Wands and the Ace of Pentacles. Yeah, they could be trying to make it seem like, okay, nah, this person is not really on your caliber here, or more importantly, this person is not really in alignment with you. Ten of Swords energy. This could be why things are either ending or they need to end. You have the Lover's card energy here. Yeah, that's what's going on here. But I feel like with the Queen of Cups energy in the Death card, there could also be somebody in their energy who is telling to tell you the truth here, or be very honest. All right, but I'm getting with the Ace of Cups and the Four of Cups energy, you need to kind of trash their ass. I'm also getting that old chilling, that old game, burn the rope of significance here. All right, but yeah, with the Ace of Cups, the Ace of Swords, the Page of Swords, and the Queen of Swords, there could be other people who actually know about this, whether it's like their friends, their family members, or whatever's going on. But the thing with this person is that they ain't gonna say shit. Yeah, I feel like this person is not gonna say anything to you guys here with Three Swords. Even if they do hurt you, they don't mean to hurt you, but it's just like, this is just what it is, okay? Let's go ahead and see what this person's actually like thinking about the situation. I'm going to pull some cards here, give me a second. I know y'all love when I pull the cards. All right, let's see what this person is thinking about the situation here. All right, for some of you guys here, this person could be dealing with you because they need a ride or transportation, or this could be why you're dealing with them, or they're having dealings with somebody. For some of you guys here, they may need a ride or transportation from somebody, and they could be trying to disguise it as that when it's not really that. We know what it is. For us, you guys here, this person could be asking for a sign on what they should do next and how they should proceed with the reading, or not with the reading, with the situation at hand. All right, or more importantly, you could be asking for a sign. But for some of you guys here, this could also be somebody who, like, they got sexualized, okay, when they were a child, or in their children, like when they were in their younger years. That's kind of what happened to them. But whoever this person is, some of you guys here, they could have Pisces placements, or you have Pisces placements. And it's so funny because now we're in Saturn and Pisces, so like I said, this is going to be coming out, okay, or this is brought to the forefront. Like, yeah. Also, at this current time, being here, this person could literally be watching you and knowing that you're watching them. All right, and they're kind of trying to figure out what they should do. Also, the angel number 12, 12, 12 and 444 could be a significance here. But yeah, this person here, they know that they're stabbing you in the back. Okay, collective. This person knows that they're stabbing you in the back. But the thing is that, more importantly, this person could think that there's, you know, they think that you're very spiritual, even if you don't do spell work or things of that nature. They equate your spiritual nature or your spiritual ranking or what you do or your practices, your rituals and routines to that, even if you don't do that. Like, for example, spell work here, this person may feel like you're going to do a jar spell on them, or more importantly, in the past, they could have tried to do this to somebody else before and they end up being in a jar spell. And it says, I know I lied, okay, but I love you. So this person does have feelings for you, or they have some type of feels for you here, but they know that they're fucking lying. They know they're lying here. Yeah, this person may try to get you to pull up, come through and kick it, okay? Or like, this could be like what you're on and you don't really realize what's going on, okay, collective. But yeah, for some of you guys here, this person may view you as a boss or a manager, or you got your shit together. You could be in a position at work, like you're in a position of power here. You have like this bossy boss, successful hustler kind of vibe, like you the shit vibe, okay? 555, that's what they think. But yeah, this person could definitely be trying to keep their hope together that this can kind of work out, or more importantly, hoping that you don't find out. For some of you guys here, this person could be hoping that, you know, they become a boss or a manager like you, or they're trying to figure out, damn, how the fuck you did that? Like, that's so cool, okay? Excuse me, but I have Keisha Cole, so for some of you guys, you could be hearing a Keisha Cole song. I don't really know her zodiac sign, but I think Keisha Cole is like a water sign or earth sign. I can't really put my finger on it, but it says, when I was a geisha, he was a samurai. Like, this person could definitely have a wounded spirit here, or more importantly, you have encounter energies like them either in your past lives or in the past. All right, for those of you guys here, you have encountered this person in a past life or a previous lifetime. That's why things can feel so familiar or so intense. But let's go ahead and see what you need to know, what your spirit team is trying to get you to know. Yeah, the first card I have here is bring a friend. So for some of you guys here, they could definitely have like a friend either they bring around them all the time, they're always hanging out with, or just simply is like connected to them at the hip, okay? That could definitely be who they're dealing with. Yeah, and this is the time to pack it up. For some of you guys here, this friend may, you know, be packing everything up, or more importantly, they're the one packing. You know how, what's her name? Janet Jackson was like, who's the one that bending? For some of you guys, the friend could be doing the bending, or they're bending the friend up. Somebody getting bent up, okay? Man or female. But yeah, also what you need to know at this current time, being here is rock the boat, okay? So like I said, you may be trying to figure out if you want to rock the boat, if you don't want to rock the boat, but this person isn't trying to antagonize you or rock the boat. All right, also astrology could be of significance here. And remember, I just pulled out this Pisces card, and we're in Saturn and Pisces, so that is very significant. So this is something that could be like harboring or it's festering inside of them, and they like, look, I gotta get it out, or like, that's gonna be how they acting. But the next card that you need to know right here, it says no permission from this person or their ancestors. So I thought I was going on. Yeah, it's so funny how the Hope card came out over here, and then now we have the Hopeless card over here. So you could be hopeless here, or like, more importantly, this is a hopeless situation. All right, and I feel like your ancestors and you period know this, okay? Or you need to know this is a hopeless situation. However, this person don't want you to think that. Also, whatever you need to know as well, Kareem Ray Bailey, for some of you guys, you could be hearing her music or have a song by her. But yeah, we have the number 5, significant changes, shifts, and understandings are going to be happening here. And then it says, this person is one clown short of a circus. So maybe they try to add you to this little circus of madness and bullshit they got going on here, y'all. But yeah, I feel like you may need to walk away from this person for good, or they're worried about you walking away for good. Because this person is a player, or more importantly, they like to play. You know that movie, Super Play That Game? Like, there could be a significance here, but it's like, it's not cool when a rabbit got a gun. You know what I'm saying? Like, you like to play, but you don't like to feel played. All right, but yeah, for some of you guys, skincare is significant. Okay, so like I said, this person could be having like pimply skin, okay, with this like body acne or period, and their skin is breaking out. For some of you guys, so this could even be like your skin breaking out all of a sudden. This could be like your body rejecting them, and you're not really sure where that shit's coming from. That's why. All right, but what she needs to know at this current time being here is that you could also have hidden talents here. That's why this person looks at you like a boss or a manager, or like they see you in this amazing kind of way despite the situation. But also a shooting or a headshot could be a significance. Maybe this person talks about it, or they did it to somebody, or vice versa. But pay attention to that, and more importantly, your ancestors finna shoot their ass with a headshot because they trying to play in your face. Anything, let's see what else y'all need to know. Yeah, it says you're burnt out. So whoever this person is, baby, they burnt and they turned. This person is burnt out. It could be for the streets. So more importantly, they've been burnt out, turned out, and guess exactly what it is, okay? But yeah, also I'm getting like, somebody could be giving you bad advice, or more importantly, this person could be getting bad advice about the situation, or how they're handling it, or how they decide to go. All right, but yeah, you need to change lanes, or they could have been getting bad advice. Like, they could have thought about changing lanes or doing something the right way, and somebody was like, nah, don't do that, don't do that, don't do that. All right, but a road trip could be a significance. Maybe you, this person, talked about a road trip, or they could have recently went on one, or you did. Whoever they be going on with their road trip with, pay attention. But I feel like you're vibing high. You need to continue to vibrate high with the two part and stay in balance. All right, in the near future, let's see what else we need to know. Let's pull. In the near future, you're gonna catch this person off guard. You're gonna catch them off guard. A more important, this may even catch you off guard. This is why you're on this reading. All right, but yeah, this is definitely a city boy or a city girl, or they try to, you know, act like that. They are driven by the threes. This will be like pussy money, weed, cars, clothes, hoes. All right, the whole lifestyle, the fast life, whatever it is. But this bad news is on the way, either to this person or to you, or both. All right, for some of you guys, this could be a male that you're dealing with, your masculine energy, or somebody who's a feminine in their masculine energy. Last card here, for some of you guys, sigils. You may be seeing sigils, ruins, or coins, or you may deal with these when it comes to your spiritual practice, okay, or your rituals and routines. But yes, I have nice nasty conversations. So you could have a nice nasty conversation, or this may go nice nasty with this person, or they could be having this with the third party, okay, or with this whoever was going on. But for some of you guys here, yeah, 600-pound life. You could have recently heard a reference regarding this. Somebody could be like large and in charge, if you know what I'm saying, weight wise. Okay, somebody could also have a really, really nice smile. You could have a nice smile. Also have the initial E. Somebody could have an E prominently in their name. You have a K here. Okay, a K in their name. Somebody could also be an Android user, or they have multiple phones, and one of the phones just happens to be an Android. All right, somebody may also love the rain. Okay, and then we have Leo here as well. Yeah, and then I have your intuition being increased for the specific reason, or will be increased after this, okay? Let's go ahead and see what's hidden in the situation. I'm going to pull these and that's it. All right, so what's hidden is that this person's reputation is a joke. Like, if you think this person got, like, a good reputation, or people be checking for them, or whatever's going on, this person's reputation is a joke. Or, more importantly, your reputation is going to be a joke if you continue to deal with this person. Also, what's hidden is that somebody could definitely be having butterflies here about the situation, about you, them, etc. Or butterfly, like tattoos or butterflies could be a significance, period. What's hidden is that whoever did there on the download, whether it's the man or a female, there's some type of brawl or drama going on. If it's the man, it's the man brawl, a man drama. If it's girls, it's a cat fight or a petty ass drama. All right, for some of you guys here, somebody could definitely have like a rental, or a rental could be a significance, like a rental property. All right, and then I have maybe. So like somebody could be getting a rental or Airbnb, or like, you know, something about rent is of significance here. Yeah, give me 1 second, y'all. But yeah, we have a number 9 as well too. So 9 talks about karmic changes, release, leveling up, you know, getting to that final cycle, that final level. Let's see what else is hidden here. Let's just say Yeah, I feel like what's hidden as well too is that this narrative is going to be debunked. So what's hidden is that this person could be trying to get this narrative or this drama or this information debunked to where people feel like it's not true. But yeah, what's hidden is that this person knows that this is the ultimate betrayal here, okay? For some of you guys here, what's hidden as well is that they could have a hidden or concealed weapon here, okay, or somebody they're dealing with. But yeah, this person is trying to trauma bond to you, whoever their trauma bond is to, that knows that they're on the DL. This person could be selling information on this person, so that could be what the brawl is going on behind the scenes, because somebody's blackmailing them, trying to sell the information, or, you know, it's getting real messy over here. Eight of Wands, some type of communication and stuff don't want to come out, okay? But this is the reading, all right? I'm not going to go too deep into this because my camera is about to die. I wish it wasn't dying, all right? But I will see you guys in the next one.